selection by President Berman.
Thank you, Lord.
Good morning.
Good morning.
A moment of reflection. So it would be about a moment. We'll not tire you out. I'm going to reflect this morning on another characteristic of the fruit of the Spirit. And this one will be faith. And Hebrews 11:1 says, now faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. We all have faith. There's no big faith and no little faith. Because Romans 12:3 says, everyone has received the measure of faith. So we all, if we are God's children, we have received that measure of faith. Hallelujah. Now faith means that we are confident of what we hope for, convinced of things what we do not see. Faith is giving substance to the things that we hope for. But laying hold of the unrealities and bringing them into reality.
That's right.
Faith is the present tense. Hope is the future tense. So if we continue to hope for things, we will not see them. We have to open our mouths and bring it into reality. That's why Jesus said, thou shalt say, whosoever say, shall say unto the mountain. You got to say it. You can't think it. You can't hope. I mean, you can't just, you know, be neutral about it, but you got to say it.
Right.
He said, say unto this mountain, be thou removed and be thou cast into the sea, and shall not doubt in his heart. So faith is really a heart thing. It's not a head thing. Sometimes, you know, you think you got faith in you. You got thinking about something. You believe in God for something, but it's just really in your head. But it's got to come from the heart.
Amen.
It say, but shall say unto the mountain, be thou removed, be thou cast into the sea, and shall not doubt in his heart, but shall believe that those things which he says shall come to pass. He shall have whatsoever he saith.
Yes.
Now, don't get in trouble with going around saying, you know, I believe for this one, and I believe for that one, because it's not God's will. This is talking about God's will in your life. So you can hope and believe and do all you want to about something, but if it's not God's will for your life, you can forget. Okay, we all have faith because it's in the fruit of the Spirit.
That's right.
And if we're born again, we do have that fruit of the Spirit.
That's right.
But what we need to do is loose it. We need to loose it. Saying it is not, it's not enough to have it in your heart, but you got to turn it loose. And what I say, and I've already said, you have to open your mouth and say it. Use your lips and your mouth and say it, because we know that's how the world became to exist, because God spoke it. He didn't create the world by anything that we can see, but he spoke it. He brought those things, those unrealities, into reality so we could see them. Hallelujah. Praise God. So today I'm going to end up with saying, I remember when I was keeping my mother, and I wasn't working, didn't have no income, and I don't know why I wanted lilies so bad, but I really wanted some lilies. And I didn't have the money to buy them, so my neighbor had a driveway, a long curvy driveway, and on either side she had lilies, lilies, lilies. So I said something to her about having some of those lilies when it was time that I could get them. She said, okay. So when it came time to get them, she acted like she didn't want me to have them. So I got mad with the devil. And I said, devil, I'm going to have some lilies. I don't know where they're coming from. I don't know how I'm going to get, but I'm going to have some lilies. Matter of fact, I put the shovel in my trunk, so when I was driving along the road and saw lilies alongside the road, I was going to dig up some. But that didn't come to pass. But anyway, I got mad at the devil, and I told him, I said, devil, I'm going to have some lilies. I said, I don't know where they're coming from. I don't know how I'm going to get them. And so I continued to work in my yard because it was something that I could do while I was keeping her. And I worked in my yard, and once in a while I would say, devil, I'm going to have me some lilies. Mm-hmm. So one day I was out there working, and this man came along, and he stopped. And he introduced himself, and he says, I see you working in your yard a lot. I say, it's really pretty. I say, thank you. He said, you know, I have a lily farm, and I want you to come over there, and I'll give you some lilies.
There you go.
I said, Lord, I thank you. So I went over there, and he filled up my trunk with lilies. Now, this is just to show you, lilies are just beautiful flowers. They're not, you know, your health, and they're not your finances. So this is just saying that if God don't do it, if I got faith and I can believe God for something as simple as some lilies,
right,
then you can believe God for your health, your finances, and all these other things. Because the more you know, if you know your Father, if you really know Him the way He is to be known, you won't have any problem believing Him for the things that you want
and
the things that you need. And I didn't need those. I just wanted them. So He is a good Father. And you know, and that man didn't only fill my trunk up, but he came by one afternoon. I was out there one evening, and he had a small pickup truck, and he had the bed full of lilies. So he gave those to me. And then after that, from time to time, I could be gone somewhere and come back, and there in my driveway at the end of the garage would be plants, different plants and bushes and flowers and things. And he did that. He did that until he sold his lily farm.
Amen.
So praise God. Amen. Just, you know, loosen up your faith.
Amen.
Loosen your faith. God is good.
Amen.
Hallelujah. And he, you know, he has already made sure that we can be victorious in our walk with him. Because he has given us all things already, all things pertaining to life and godliness in Christ Jesus. And you just need to look in that mirror of the word and reflect what's in your spirit so it will come and you can agree with it in your mind.
Amen.
Praise God. Thank you.